Hey everybody, this is Osprey from MyChartCoach.com, and we're taking a look here at Bitcoin Cash. Yeah, it pulled back here and took a little bounce down here off of this key support zone. So it came down here and hit exactly at 657, 658, bounced off of that level. Now it's back above EMAs 4, 8, and 13. If it can hold those levels, look for it to work its way back up to that $900 resistance zone. Okay, so the closing price on the 19th of June will be the key level to break at 908. If it can get above that level, it could possibly run up there to that 50-day simple moving average at 964. So it's got a nice bounce going, just has to stay above EMAs 4, 8, and 13 and break through 900. All right, take a look at GBTC here. This is Bitcoin Investment Trust. This trade's over the counter. It's supposed to follow Bitcoin's movement. You can see it had a huge day today. It closed up nearly 20%. It's been on this big pullback, and then it finally got the bounce today. It did close above EMAs 4, 8, and 13. And so as long as it stays above EMA 4 at 943, it is in play for a bounce. If it dropped below, it would be a risk to hold. The key levels to break now are this middle Bollinger Band at 300-day simple moving average. If it can get above 11 and turn it into support, that's going to signal it wants to head higher. Fail to get above this middle Bollinger Band is going to signal more downside risk. Okay, take a look at GBR. This was the big winner today. Closed up 110%. That was a really nice follow through after the reversal yesterday. So it formed that black candle last week, and then on Friday it had that nice bounce, and then today it had that nice, really nice follow through. So this is a really impressive move. As you can see here, there is a gap between high of day on Friday and low of day today. So if for some reason the share price does pull back, look for that gap to fill, and a drop down there to around 475. That would fill the gap, and that's down there near EMA 4 at 512. So it's going to need to keep pushing higher here. Today's candle did form above the upper Bollinger Band. You can see the upper wick did hit this 13 resistance level, so there was some profit taking here. If we look at the GBR monthly chart, I had to go back 20 years, okay, to look at resistance here. And so now it's hitting this 2002 high close on the monthly chart right here at $12, and it's lined up with that 300-day simple moving average at 1202. That's the blue line right there. It's just popping onto the screen. That's going to be the huge level to break. You know, this month's candle will not, the candle will not set until the last trading day at the end of the month, and so a lot can happen between now and then. But right now it's hitting these 20-year high levels. It would be bullish if it did close above the 2008 high close level. That's at $8 for the month. That would be very bullish. If it pulls back below there, that could signal a temporary resistance. As you can see here, the $8 level has been a big resistance zone. It is breaking out above 2016, 17, and 18 high close resistance levels. So a monthly close above 450 would be bullish. Same thing, there's a gap this month on the chart. You know, you could get a drop down there. This is the first trading day of the month. A drop down to the high of last month would fill the gap. And so so we'll see here if it can bust through resistance. Check out the 15-minute chart for GBR. You can look at this nice multi-day run here. I mean, it started way down here around $1, and then it ran all the way up to $13. I mean, that's a monster move right there. This is a 10-bagger. You know, this is 1,000% gain in a couple days. And so is it going to keep pushing higher? Well, this inverted hammer here, this inverted candle, this was a red flag that did signal a temporary top on the 15-minute chart. Anytime you get an inverted hammer or a doji forming during an uptrend, you know, many times that could signal a temporary top. It did here, a red candle followed, and it's been pulling back ever since. Has to get back above the middle Bollinger Band at 1024. Failed to do that, and the downside risk is it drops down to this 50 simple moving average at 705. You could see the gap here on the chart between high of day on Friday and low of day today, and so a drop down to that 100 simple moving average at 450 would fill the gap. Okay, take a look at RSYS. Huge move today, closed up 120%. All the magic happened in the gap up open. It closed on Friday way down here at 70 cents, and then it opened today way up here at $1.60. What was it, like $1.62 it opened at, or opened at $1.61? And $1.62 was the high. So all the magic happened in the first trade of the day. And then it was the bears were driving it lower. It did a rally off of low of day. So this is a good sign. They pushed it off of 40. What has to happen to head higher is it has to close above 160 and turn that level into support. If 160 turns into resistance, you could see the candles work back into the bands. And the downside risk is it comes down here to the red line, the 200-day simple moving average at 93 or EMA 4 at 104. So it'd be bullish above 160, below 160 signals downside risk. Look at the big volume spike today. If you look here at the RSYS weekly chart, so each candle on this chart represents 1 week of trading. You can see the giant gap up open this week. The upper Bollinger Band's way down here at 116. It did gap up above that 50-week moving average at 104, so a weekly close above that level would be bullish. And it also gapped up above the middle Bollinger Band at 78. So if both those levels turn into support, a new uptrend could begin. Right now, it's hitting this key resistance zone from 2017. It needs to bust through this level, this 160, you know, you could call it 150 to 170 level, and that would signal it wants to head higher. If it can close above the bottom of this candle, that's this red line here, that should be the signal it wants to keep pushing. If it stalls out here, the candles could work back into the bands. Okay, look at ADMP, closed up 50% today. Another kind of gap up open play. You know, it closed on Friday way down here at 320. It opened way up here. Notice how a small candle formed today, small real candle body. Even though it went way down here to the 200-day simple moving average, which it bounced off of, you know, it closed near the open. And so as long as it holds this 200 and 300-day simple moving average, it will signal more upside potential. It also closed above high close in May. That's at 470. It needs to stay above that level. If it pulled back below, then you could see this 300-day simple moving average retested. Right now, it's hitting this January high close resistance level. This is the highest close in 2018. And so if it can break above that level, what you'd be looking for is a run up here to the October high close, which is up near 565. Notice there was a big volume spike today. Okay, check out SAEX here. Closed up 42%. Really big move. It did end up closing just above the 300-day simple moving average at 229. So that will be the key level to stay above. If it stays above 229, above the blue line, that should signal it wants to head higher. It hit that level and traded above it intraday on Friday, but it pulled back, way back. You know, this is very similar to the other chart we were looking at where it had the big black candle for GBR. You know, SAEX did the same thing, pulled way back and then boom, retrace the whole gains. Now, if it drops back below that 300-day simple moving average, that would signal consolidation, and you could see that 200-day simple moving average at 183 tested. If it breaks above, what you're looking for is a close above this high close resistance level from December. That's a right around 265, and then just above that at 290, you have a high close from back here in September. So those are the two key resistance zones to break above. Okay, let's look at CEI here. Okay, closed up 61%. Another nice move. This was a stock that pulled back on Friday as well. It had made a good move last week. It came down here and it filled this gap. Okay, so there was a gap between low of day on this candle and high of day on this candle between Wednesday and Thursday of last week. And so Friday's candle filled the gap. Many times a gap fill is a catalyst for a bounce, a downward gap fill. So keep that in mind. It did have a big bounce and a gap up open today. What's going on here is it has to break the gold line. That's the 100-day simple moving average at 92. If it can close above that level, that should be the signal it wants to head higher. There is a gap up here in March between low of day on this candle and high of day on this upper wick. If it comes up here to the 200-day simple moving average of 240, it could possibly fill that gap. Now, if it fails to break above 92, that would signal possible consolidation. Right now, EMA 4 at 65 is holding. As long as it keeps holding, the chart is strong. If it were to close below, that could signal consolidation. The downside risk is it would come down here and test that 50-day simple moving average at 41. Okay, check out Dry's. Closed up nearly 8% today. This was nice bullish reversal confirmation. On Friday, you can see this black candle formed inside of the previous red candle. That had formed bullish homing pigeon reversal pattern. And so today's candle confirm that pattern. And so now the candles are back above EMAs 4, 8, and 13. As long as they hold and the candles are staying above this 553 support zone, the pink and lime lines, that's going to signal upside potential. What you'd be looking for the candles working back to that recent high close, which is up here on the 25th, which would be right around 650. Now, if it were to drop back below 538 or even 550, that would be a red flag. The downside risk is it would come down here to this middle Bollinger Band and test that $5 support zone. As long as the middle Bollinger Band, which is also the 20-day simple moving average, is holding, The uptrend is intact. If it were to break, that would signal downside risk. Okay, let's look at GST here. Keep an eye on this one. This is the 15-minute chart. As you can see here, it's setting up for a potential bounce. It channeled out sideways today. You know, the trading got really tight here heading into the close, and then it had a little push. The big thing here is this gold line. That's the 100 simple moving average at 57. It's the top moving average on the 15-minute chart for GST. If you see it break above 57, that should signal it wants to head higher, and then it would just have to stay above that level. You could see the 300 simple moving average is the bottom moving average down here at 55. So all the moving averages are converged between 55 and 57. This is either going to break out to the upside or break down to the downside, so keep an eye on GST. Okay, take a look at TGC here. It closed up 17% today. This has been on a nice, I guess you could call it a two-week run now. It started running last week when some volume came in on the 25th, or I guess it didn't come in until this big candle here on the 27th, but it was heating up here. It was on a multi-day run last week. It pulled back on Friday, and then today it pushed higher again. It did close above the high close here from April and May, and so that does signal more upside potential. Now it's hitting this January high close. This red line is the highest close for all of 2018. If it could close above that, that'd be really bullish. And then the second key level is the top of this white candle here from back in December at 95. If it could turn 95 into support, that's when it could really get moving. So keep an eye on it. You can see volume's been picking up a little bit down here. Okay, take a look at TNTR. Closed up 13.5% today. You can see this has been in a really strong downtrend. All the candles have been forming below this dotted purple line until there was a close above back in June. That level failed to hold, and it dropped further. You could see there was this gap between low of day on this candle and high of day on this candle. Well, that gap filled yesterday. You can see the upper wick on yesterday's, or I should say Friday, the upper wick on Friday's candle filled that gap, and the share price pulled back. The big level on this chart is the dotted purple line. It needs to close above 35 and turn that into support to get a new uptrend going. As you can see on this chart, TNTR is a risk to hold when candles are forming below that middle Bollinger Band. Okay, let's look here. It also, well, I guess that gap filled already. Let's take a look at LBIX. Closed up 14% today. It's hitting the 300-day simple moving average. This is the third day in a row. It's been bumping up against it, currently at 146. If it closes above that level, that should be the signal it wants to head higher. You can see all these upper wicks on the candles have been breaking above that level and pulling back. Once the algorithms, once the machines, once the computers finally let a close above 146, that should be our clue that LBIX wants to finally head higher, so keep an eye on it. Fail to break 146 would signal not ready to go. Okay, look at ASTC here. Keep an eye on this one. It had a big pullback, and then today it found some support. It did close up 16%. Volume's very light. We'll see if volume would pick up here at 244,000 shares. Back here on the 19th, check out the big candle. Okay, so this black spinning top formed. This is why we don't hold when the black candle forms above the upper Bollinger Band. That's this solid purple line, because the candles do work back into the bands nine times out of 10, and that's what happened right here. And so you check out the big volume spike. There was huge volume on the 19th. And so, you know, we'll see if people are still holding here. I mean, there hasn't been much volume afterwards, so it seems like there has to be a lot of people still holding the stock. It came down here and hit the middle Bollinger Band and the 200-day simple moving average and bounced. As long as it holds $3, that uptrend's still intact. It closed back above EMA's 4, 8, and 13 and the 300-day simple moving average. If it stays above 358, that's the blue line. That should signal it wants to head higher. Look for it, if it does, to work its way back up into the fives. Okay, so yeah, if it fails to stay above that 300 simple moving average, that would make it a risk to hold. Okay, or just signal consolidation, could pull back, all that kind of stuff. Take a look at DRUS. This is Drone USA. Trades over the counter. This is the big winner today. Closed up over 600%. It kept pushing higher. This got above the middle Bollinger Band down here at 099. And then it also got above the 50-day simple moving average at 022. If it can stay above this 2-cent support zone, that should signal it wants to head higher. As you can see here, the last close above the 50-day simple moving average was way back here in January. And so if it can stay above, what you're looking for tomorrow is a run up to that 100-day simple moving average at 053. That will be the next big level to break. Fail to break that level, that would signal a temporary top. You know, you can see there is some resistance up in this zone. You know, you've got some trading up here. And so we'll see if it can bust through. You know, if it could close back above that 100-day simple moving average, that would be really bullish. There was a giant volume spike today, and it closed near high of day. So, you know, this has a chance to push higher. Now, if it were to pull back into the bands and then it got below that 50-day simple moving average, that would be a red flag. That would be a sell zone, lock and gain zone, or signal. You know, it would signal that it's possibly going to consolidate if it drops below 2 cents. Okay, take a look at DRUS 15. Minute chart. Look at the really strong push here. You know, huge winner. Look at the giant gains today. You know, it had the tight Bollinger Bands on Friday. On the first candle of the day, it got above all the moving averages, and then it just was riding EMA's 4 and 8 support higher. When it tested EMA 8 at 130 here, that support level held, and it kept pushing higher. And so as long as it's staying above EMA 4 and 293, the chart's super strong. Once it closes below, then it could consolidate. As long as that middle Bollinger Band at 222 is holding, this uptrend is still intact and it has more upside potential. Once you see a drop below that level, that'll signal you know, risk to hold and that it could pull back. Okay, let's look at BIOAQ for the last ticker symbol in this video. Closed up 22% today. This had nice follow through for the last, 4 days. It's hitting the key resistance level. It's the closing price on June 18th. And then back here in March, you can see this close. These two red lines here are the big levels to break. And then also you can see the upper wick hit this third red line. And what that is the, lining up with the gap over here. And so I guess the gap is up here. So it's got to break above, these key resistance levels. And then if it can get above this, what is it? Seven, where was the high today? High was 6.8. And so if it can bust above the 6.8 to 7 resistance zone, then it could possibly run up here to this first gap. There's a gap up here, a gap fill to, a run to 10 cents would fill that gap. So it has nice fall through. The one red flag here that we're seeing is a gap between high of day on Friday and low of day today. A drop down to EMA 4 at 5 cents would fill that gap. Okay, thanks for viewing this video. Come check out the chat for more charts and technical analysis. Okay, thank you.